Hey guys, today we're going to show you how to hook up a trailer. Before we start our hookup, we want to make sure that the wheels are secured. We are now about to finalize our hookups to the trailer to make this safe. Now, things that we have to factor in is the height of the hitch and also that our hitch and our receiver are rated for the total weight of our trailer. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to now lift up the jack. Now for this particular trailer, to know that the coupler latch is actually engaged properly, you can see here that you cannot see through it. So once the ball is all the way in, you now see through it and we can put our pin through. That way we know it's attached. Next, we're gonna hook up the chains. We're gonna have our hooks facing out. We're gonna make sure our chains are crossed. Now, if the chain's too long for whatever reason, we can twist them a bit to take some length out of it. So the purpose of crossing your chains, if this assembly fails for whatever reason, you have something break over here, what we hope is that the trailer will land into our cradle and we can stop this thing. If they're just separate, if they're parallel with each other, it's just going to drop on the ground and you're going to have no control over this trailer. Next, we're going to do the brake lead. This particular trailer is hooked up with electric brakes. So the purpose of it is, if this fails, the chain fails, and the trailer just needs to stop, it'll engage the brakes. Now what we're doing is we're hooking it up through the bumper. Now the reason being is if for some reason all of this stuff breaks away, well, that's going to break away with it. So the bumper is most likely going to stay intact. So if this whole assembly rips off, then our brakes are going to engage. We are now beginning our pre-check. So what we're going to do is we're actually going to test our emergency brakes on the trailer. So we now have we have taken out our seven-way. And we've also removed our breakaway as well. So what we're relying on is now that the trailer thinks that the truck is separated from it and is now engaging the brakes. So we want to make sure that the brakes work and that this battery's working. And we're going to try to roll forward. And our brakes are working the way they're supposed to, just off the trailer. We're now going to hook up our seven-way. So there's a little stopper on here that you can see for the plug. What we're trying to do is we're trying to get that underneath the cover. That way it hooks in there and stays in there. So most of these are designed to work like that. So if your truck doesn't have that cover, it's broken off or whatever, I would replace that because that helps keep the plug in place. Now another little trick that we do for the wire for the seven-way, we hook it with the pin. This keeps all the wire out of the way because on some trailers, this wire might be really long. It can drag. We want to keep everything away from the chains. So you can see everything's just tucked away and then you can always take it out after. If you own a trailer with electric brakes and your truck is not equipped with a trailer brake controller, you're going to have to put one in. So right now we're doing our light check. So this is, can you turn the running lights off? Running lights on. Okay. Okay, we'll do brake. Okay, left signal. Now right signal. Also make sure that your lights for your license plate are working as well. Well guys, hopefully this video helps you out for covering the basics of hooking up your trailer.